Why do people with pre-existing heart disease seem to have a greater risk of severe COVID-19? We know from epidemiologic study that patients with severe COVID-19 are more likely to have high blood pressure or hypertension, coronary artery disease, diabetes, congestive heart failure, and obesity. We know that anyone with pre-existing heart disease is always at higher risk for doing poorly when they develop anything that is a stress to the body, like a bacterial or viral infection. The combination of diabetes, high blood pressure, and obesity may confer a poor outcome, but the reasons for this is still not well understood. Is high blood pressure a risk factor for severe COVID-19 infection? We have observed during the COVID-19 pandemic that patients with high blood pressure are at higher risk for severe disease. However, there are several caveats to this. First of all, hypertension is a highly prevalent disease in our population, meaning that many people have high blood pressure and are being treated with medications for this. Second, we know that as people age, the prevalence of hypertension increases with age. Since COVID-19 has more serious effects on older adults, it is not unusual to see that more patients will have high blood pressure. Are certain blood pressure medications, such as ACE inhibitors and ARBs, also a risk factor for COVID-19 infection or illness? ACE inhibitors and ARBs are commonly used medications to treat hypertension or high blood pressure, coronary artery disease, and congestive heart failure. The SARS-CoV-2 virus, also known as the novel coronavirus, enters cells in the lung through the angiotensin-converting 2 enzyme. The virus attaches to the cells and then enters the cells through this enzyme. Doctors and scientists have been investigating whether there is a link between the use of medications like ACE inhibitors and ARBs and the development of coronavirus. As of right now, we have no evidence to say that the use of these medications leads to severe COVID-19 illness. The American Heart Association and the American College of Cardiology, both large societies here in the United States, have recommended that patients do not stop these medications. These medications are very important in the treatment of heart disease, and stopping these medications may lead to the decompensation of your heart disease. As of right now, we recommend that you continue taking your medications and speak to your physician if there are any changes in your condition. If you are having newly diagnosed high blood pressure or heart disease, your physician may decide which medication is best for you for treating these conditions in the setting of the COVID pandemic. Is there truth to reports that COVID-19 infection can impair heart function and even cause heart attacks? The short answer to this question is yes. Let me explain to you why. First, in the setting of COVID-19 illness, your body is going to work very hard to combat the disease. In patients with pre-existing heart disease, the heart is going to have to work harder during the illness. And in the setting of this, it may lead to some heart damage. We measure an enzyme called troponin, which is found in your heart muscle and is released into the bloodstream during heart damage. We do know that any elevation in this heart enzyme troponin can lead to serious poor outcomes. Second, we know that the virus can cause critical illness in patients. It is well known that when the body is working very hard under the stress of illness, that the heart function may decrease. And this is called stress-induced cardiomyopathy. This type of illness typically improves as the body heals. The virus itself can also affect the heart muscle. It can infect the heart and also causes decreases in heart function. Finally, we know that the body can have a profound inflammatory response to the virus, and this is something called cytokine storm. In the setting of all the inflammation and the infection, we have also noted that patients can have a hypercoagulable state. This means that the blood has a higher propensity to clot, and this can lead to things like heart attacks and strokes. What is a pulse oximeter, and is this a good at-home diagnostic tool for COVID-19? A pulse oximeter is a small portable device that can measure the oxygen saturation in your red blood cells. It is typically a small device that slips over the top of your finger. The device emits light, and through this light, it is analyzed and you can measure the saturation of oxygen. You can make this measurement while you're sitting in a chair or laying in your bed, but it is also very helpful to take this measurement while walking around in your home. If you notice changes with your oxygen saturation while you're walking around or you're at rest, you can then call your physician to take the next steps in your treatment. When would you recommend heart disease patients use video visits to see their doctor? During the COVID-19 pandemic, telemedicine has really taken off. This has been a great way for patients to connect with their doctors during this time when we are practicing social distancing. We encourage all of our patients to reach out to their physician's offices and schedule a video visit, both for sick visits and routine follow-ups. Please do not ignore symptoms like chest pain, shortness of breath, decreased ability to walk around, or lightheadedness. Experiencing any of these symptoms should cause you to call your doctor's office and schedule a visit to speak with your physician. Routine follow-ups are also extremely important to help ensure that all of our patients stay healthy during this time. Some tips to help you get the most out of your video visit is to measure your blood pressure and heart rate on a home blood pressure monitor, check your weight, and have all of your medications close by in order to review with your physician. Not only can your physician review all the things that are needed to keep your heart healthy, but you can review the prevention of coronavirus and all the signs and symptoms of COVID-19, and this way make a plan with your physician in case you start to feel ill. What should people do if they feel they are having a cardiac event, heart attack, or stroke? If you are experiencing any of the signs of a heart attack, such as chest pain, shortness of breath, lightheadedness, dizziness, or loss of consciousness, please do not ignore these symptoms and do not hesitate to call 911 or go to the closest emergency room. In addition, if you are experiencing any signs or symptoms of stroke, such as slurred speech, asymmetric facial symmetry, numbness or tingling on one side of your body, or the inability to move your arm or leg, again, please do not hesitate to call 911 or go to the closest emergency room. I want to reassure all of you that your emergency room physicians are ready to evaluate you and treat you for these conditions. Please do not be afraid to come to a hospital. We will take care to prevent the spread of COVID-19, take all of the proper precautions, and we are ready to do all the necessary procedures to treat patients who are having heart attack and stroke.